Hey guys, it's Josh, Stoney Ridge Farmer. Welcome to the farm vlog today. Today we're out on a ranch in Southwest Virginia, and I wanted to show you guys how the fences are built. So we're getting ready to build fences here on the farm at the Stoney Ridge Farm, and we drove up about a half hour north into Virginia to take a look at my stepdad's ranch up here. We've got some beef cows here. These are Black Angus cows. We're going to take you around the ranch here. We're going to show you the different types of fences that we have on the ranch, and we're just trying to make the determination of how we're going to build our fencing and how we're going to keep our cows when we get ready to start having cows. We're probably about 2 years out from having cows on our property, and like with anything on a farm, you're constantly in a research phase here. So we're researching the cows, we're researching the fence, we're researching the gates, all this stuff, what works, what doesn't work. We'll take you around, we'll show you all these different types of fences on the ranch here. Come on along with me, let's have some fun. Woo!
Stoney Ridge. Farm, Stoney Ridge. Stoney Ridge Farm.
So the first exciting news I'd like to share with you today is that Mrs. Stoney Ridge got her first big buck this morning. Mrs. Stoney Ridge is okay, but her first buck is not okay. Mrs. Stoney Ridge bagged her first buck this morning with the front end of her Toyota Tacoma. About $4,000 worth of damage. Ugh. Bummer. So folks, when it comes to fencing, we've got several different options. We have different options for gates, different options for fence wire, different options for posts, just 1,000 different options. Normally around here, either folks run barbed wire fence, they either run 5, 6, or 7 strands of barbed wire, or they run a high tensile fence, mostly for horses, sometimes for cows. And normally with the high tensile, you have at least 1, maybe 2 lines of hot. Hot meaning electrified, meaning electric fence to keep the cows or horses off, because a cow or a horse or any sort of livestock can get hung up in a barbed wire fence and really scratch them up. The other option is a woven wire type fence. Now there are several different types of woven wire type fence. This is why we're talking about this, guys. There are a lot of options when it comes to building a fence. This is a high tensile type fence, okay? These strands, the top one is electrified, and you can see, let me pull it in a little closer. So the top one here is electrified, and the reason you know it's electrified is because it has this little rubber insulator. And then there's one here in the middle that's electrified. This is for gate support and for corners. We'll have it bound, double bound, here at each corner. Now some people only do one of these. You can do just one support. Basically it's a post, and a support piece in between, and then a piece of high tensile cable pulling them tight together so that it holds that corner. Now, if you do it with a double, it holds it twice as good, and you won't end up with a leaning fence later on in the life of the fence. Now this fence should last 25, 30 years if it's maintained correctly. This fence right here is 17 years old and it looks just as good as the day it was put up. So I would say this fence could last 30 years, maybe more than 30 years. Let's talk about how the electric wire is ran through the gate. Now that's something different, something I didn't know about. If you look right down here, there is a wire, an electrical wire, that's tapped on to both of the hot wires, one here and one here, and it goes underneath the road in this insulated wire. It goes down and it goes underneath the gate and attaches on the other side. Pretty neat. Over time, trees are going to fall on the fence and the fence is going to stretch out. In the winter time, it's going to draw up tighter. In the summertime, it's going to stretch out a little longer, and you have these tensioners right here. And you just ratchet those tensioners down and it keeps this high tensile fence in place. So right now we're hanging a gate here, guys. We're just putting a gate up on this post right here because the gate hanger, which is on the bottom, got hung up and broke off. So we're replacing that gate hanger, and I'll show you that gate hanger right here. It's right down here at the bottom, and then we're remounting right here. Now my stepdad's telling me a little trick here. If you put a self-tapping screw in right here, it'll keep this piece from sliding down and keep you from having to adjust your gate too much. So let's hang this gate. Whenever you're doing fence work like this, guys, it's a good idea to have 2 people just because you need an extra hand. We're gonna help them out a little bit today. So folks, what you need to know when you're hanging a gate like this, we're on an incline, just an ever so slight incline. Well, that means that the gate has to open this way. It has to open down the hill. In other words, if the gate opened up the hill, it would run into the ground. So we have to make sure that the gate is fairly level, and when you open it up, it swings the full range of motion without digging into the ground. Just a little bit of gate science for you. Another thing I want to show you, guys, there's a little disconnect right here. Pretty cool. You open it and close it. That way, if you want to de-energize a section of fence, you can just open that little disconnect and work on your fence. So guys, all the way on the outside perimeter of this ranch is 8 strands of high tensile, and high tensile electrified on 2 strands. Now, for the cross fencing, he basically put in electrified two-strand high tensile line. And that's enough to hold the cows for the cross fencing here. Something you may not think about, something you may not know, is there's a huge liability in livestock getting out into a public road. A car could hit it, a school bus could hit it, it could kill or injure somebody, or damage other people's property. So we gotta keep the perimeter fences really tight, and then our cross fencing isn't quite as aggressive as the outside perimeter fencing. Food for thought. Let's go over here and look at the hay bale stacks and show you how he's got the hay stacked up here to keep it dry. So right here we have the hay bale stacks, and basically he's got a system here. He has 3, 2, and then 1, and then it's tarped over the top. Now a specific size tarp, a 24 foot wide tarp, will span this and that'll keep the hay dry. And on the back side over here, I'll show you, we'll take you over here. So on the back side of this long stack of hay right here is bracing. And basically he's taken the round bales and braced them up against so he can pack it tight and then run the straps over. And then we find a use for old tires as weights to hold this tarp down. As time goes on, we'll roll the tarp back and he'll get the hay out that he needs to feed the cows. So the way it works is 20 cows will eat about 1,000 pound roll of hay per day on this ranch. So on this ranch, we have 145 acres of pasture and about 40 cows. Each bale feeds 20 cows per day. And there are 20 cows on this side of the road and 20 cows on that side of the road. So on our farm, we've decided that we're gonna use a post driver to drive our posts. We've got a lot of rocks on one side of the farm and the other side doesn't have a lot of rocks. Here's an example of a post that was driven and it kind of split at the top a little bit. Now this one here was driven and it didn't really split. And you got several over here that didn't split. So using a post driver will kind of beat the top of your post. And if you haven't seen a post driver, stay on the vlog. We'll show you what a post driver does. Basically, it just pounds a wooden post into the ground. Pounds, boom, boom. Get on out here. Dummy. Hey, donkey. So as we get out here and we talk about fencing, we need to think about a centralized location on the farm so we can put a pin like this to catch cows. Not only do you have to raise cows and you have to move them from paddock to paddock, and if you look back over this beautiful hillside here, beautiful view, there are several paddocks. There's a paddock here, and another paddock back over on this side. So some of this land is used for rotational grazing, some of it's used for hay land, and some of it's used for dual purpose. So where the land is really rough and you can't get in with haymaking equipment, kind of like right here on this hillside, then you just graze it with the cows. But if you've got land that's like way back over here, you can see those pastures over there, you can cut hay on that. Things we need to think about, guys. Things we got to think about for building fences on the farm and raising cows. So we had to move the wife's Tacoma out of the way because the jackasses over here kept trying to bite it. So here's a system they have for watering the cows here on the ranch. So we've got about 10 feeder calves over here, and these feeder calves are gonna go to market this weekend, okay? I'm not really sure what they're bringing. Stepdad rancher here, he knows a little bit more about what the cows are bringing right now. But here's his watering apparatus. Basically, he has one of these big old totes. It used to have honey in it. And this honey tote, he fills it full of water, comes over here, and drains it into this other tote so that the cows have plenty of water. How much water does one cow drink in a day, you think? We're gonna have to get back to you on the cow specs on the how much water a cow drinks. 9 glasses of water per day. Normally, guys, the cows drink out of the creek down here. And just FYI, there's money. There's government money out there right now to help with the watershed and keep animals out of the creek. So our county and our state has several grants that are out there right now to pay for 85% or 90% of the fencing and the drilling of wells to keep the cows out of the watershed and out of the creek. Now in an operation like this, it's not such a big deal, but with a big operation, say there were 200 head of cattle and they were all down in the creek, that'd be a very damaging thing for the watershed. Let's walk over here, I'll show you a different kind of fence. This is our woven wire type fence. This little section right here is ran in woven wire because this is his catch pin. This is where he draws the cows in when he gets ready to load them up on the trailer. And there's a chute over here that they run through to load up on the trailer. Now you can see how saggy this fence gets. This is helping me to make my decision on what kind of fence I want to use on my farm. Do I want something that's going to be high maintenance like this, or do I want a high tensile fence that's going to be low maintenance and easy to take care of? I'm not so happy with that. I think high tensile might be the way we go. Guys, we got a really beautiful farm here. Look at the rolling hills. Look how pretty it is. This is what a working farm is supposed to look like. Over here is a new pasture that was just seeded last year. and it's coming along really nicely. He seeded his pasture the same time I seeded mine. Folks, I just want to take you on a little journey today, a little bit of the thought process that I'm having to put into putting our new fences up. If you guys have any suggestions or any comments, please leave them down below. Don't forget to click that like button. It helps my channel a whole lot. Leaving comments helps the channel, and click the little bell if you want to see as progress goes on the farm. It'll notify you when I get a new video out. So thanks a lot for watching, guys. Please subscribe to the channel. Come on back and see me here on the Stoney Ridge Farm. We're on a little road trip today, just hanging out with the cows. Thanks a lot. All right. Woo!
Well, come on down to the Stoney Ridge. Bring your wife and bring your kids. We're living life pure and sweet. That's the way it's supposed to be, Stoney Ridge.
Guys, you hear these cows? They're growling. They're growling cows. These are West Virginia growling cows.